and less than a day after the televised execution of deposed Arab leader Yasser al-Filani, U.S. Marines stationed on high alert in the Persian Gulf were given the order to invade the small but oil-rich nation. His successor, Khaled al-Assad, conducted the high-profile execution personally on national television, accusing al-Filani of placing foreign interests ahead of those of his countrymen. While the exact time and location of the American invasion have been withheld for security reasons, the U.S. Secretary of Defense stated that the forces deployed would be significant, and that al-Assad would not be permitted to further destabilize the region through military expansionism. The Russian government released a statement today confirming the death of Imran Zakayev. According to several reliable witnesses, the ultranationalist leader who started the brutal war in Russia was killed while attempting to evade loyalist troops at a safe house in Grozny. In other news, the search for a ship lost in the Bering Strait due to a major storm has been called off. The Russian government released a statement today confirming a series of nuclear missile tests in central Russia. Although world leaders were quick to denounce the action, Russian officials maintained that the missile tests fell well within established UN protocols. No comment was received from the ultranationalist party, where rumors of a possible leadership struggle have just begun to surface. The ship, carrying a large supply of luxury automobiles, went missing 6 days ago, after having drifted off course in the Category 5 storm. And less than a day after the televised execution of deposed Arab leader Yasser al-Filani, U.S. Marines were given the order to invade the small but oil-rich nation. His successor, Khaled al-Assad, conducted the high-profile execution personally on national television, accusing al-Filani of placing foreign interests ahead of those of his countrymen. While the exact time and location of the American invasion have been withheld for security reasons, the U.S. Secretary of Defense stated that the forces deployed would be significant, and that al-Assad would not be permitted to further destabilize the region through military expansionism. The Russian government released a statement today confirming the death of Imran Zakayev. According to several reliable witnesses, the ultranationalist leader who started the brutal war in Russia was killed while attempting to evade loyalist troops at a safe house in Grozny. In other news, the search for a ship lost in the Bering Strait due to a major storm has been called off. The Russian government released a statement today confirming a series of nuclear missile tests in central Russia. Although world leaders were quick to denounce the action, Russian officials maintained that the missile tests fell well within established UN protocols. No comment was received from the ultranationalist party, where rumors of a possible leadership struggle have just begun to surface. The ship, carrying a large supply of luxury automobiles, went missing 6 days ago, after having drifted off course in the Category 5 storm.